This week at COP, a big thank you to all the incredible families who participated in last weekend's Family Worship Weekend. We enjoyed the children ushering, singing, dancing, and playing instruments. And we loved being led in worship by some awesome COP families. Let's do this again sometime, COP. This week at COP, let's take a peek at the Specialized Camp, which took place Sunday and Monday, with 140 specialized and professionals joining. Tagaytay Havens was the venue. It was truly a refreshing time in the presence of the Lord. This week at COP, we had some awesome outings to fill our Monday holiday. 137 Young Builders Department, that's our children's department workers, along with the preteen workers and their families, had their annual fellowship outing in Calamba Laguna. The time was filled with learning and fellowship. Our higher dimension choir leaders had an overnight fellowship to further their learning and to have some awesome time with one another. They were at Shirkan Resort in Lipa. 83 of our hardworking dancers spent a day in Laguna, swimming and enjoying some time with the Lord. Our Kool-Aid sets, our youth ushers, enjoyed a Kool-Aid upgrade at the Philippine Ports Authority Recreation Area. This week at COP, our COP Rangers took COP Bus 1 to Angel 1 for a work day on Monday. 46 young men took part in this fruitful day, doing field work to clear the Angel 1 site of grass and bushes and to save our jackfruit trees. If you're interested in joining these rangers in future activities, please approach your campus concierge or call Pastor Marlon at the number on the screen. This week at COP, let's take a moment to celebrate the amazingly wonderful COP members who stepped in and helped the victims of the Aroma Fire. COP, you are wonderful! And everybody said, I know. The fire took place last Friday afternoon and demolished 5 buildings in Aroma. By Saturday morning, COP, you had rallied to the occasion and we had fed 3,000 people and given away a lot of relief goods. But all day Saturday, the relief kept pouring in, clothing, blankets, towels, and other things fire victims would need. Volunteers stayed after the service Saturday night to pack these things. But many of these same volunteers ended up being stranded at COP all night, because as they were packing, the floods were rising outside. That is super dedication. By Sunday evening, Sister Aleph had to put out a call asking everyone to stop bringing donations because we had more than enough. Thank you, COP, for all your hard work, your donations, your walking through the floods to feed these children, and your love for God and His precious little ones. This week at COP, because of our missions giving, the Mighty Men in Uniform were able to reach out to the recruitment centers once again and saw 254 military souls saved. The MMU also had a whole day refresher training on Monday to retrain and keep this highly active team up to date. This week at COP, because of your missions giving, we are continually being a blessing to the pastors of other churches who join us at the monthly breakfast fellowship. And for the first time, due to the response of pastors from other areas, the breakfast fellowship was done at main campus, but with a live feed at East Campus. COP, your monthly pledge of 100 or 200 pesos is reaching farther than you'll ever know. Thank you for your continuous missions giving. This week at COP, we thank God for the open door that was presented to us in Batangas for us to hold a provincial conference. It was a full house as Pastor Joey and Pastor Alani taught about visitation, connect groups, and leadership development, all of which were well received by the delegates. And they say,
we are going to that conference 2017! Woo!
This week at COP, we are rejoicing with Marvin and Ethel Tan for the dedication of their new condo unit. A blessing from the Lord that they are using as an investment. God truly blesses the work of our hands. Coming up at COP, the Light Conference 2017 is packed with sessions and daytime tracks that are sure to help pastors, leaders, and church workers with their ministries. But did you know that the Light 2017's afternoon schedule is also for you, COP members? In fact, it's for everyone. So, come to the Holy Ghost services with Pastor Frank Bailey on November 30 and December 1 from 3 to 5 p.m. and healing services December 1 Friday, 7 p.m., December 2 Saturday, 6 p.m., and all day Sunday. These are with Pastor Dag Heward Mills, and on Sunday, 7:30 and 12:30, also with Pastor Frank Bailey. Pastora Alicia Williamson-Garcia will be in our services to provide music and worship. Bring the sick, bring yourself, and expect a powerful move of God. Coming up at COP, our finishing weekend will be here in only 3 weeks. 3 weeks to pray, 3 weeks to plan, 3 weeks until we watch the Lord do amazing things. And just in case you missed it, let's take another look at our finishing weekend video.
When God gives you a job to do, when God assigns a task to you, He doesn't give it to you to start, He gives it to you to finish. You show that you are a reliable person. You show that you are a person who can be trusted.
Only people who truly fail are the people who quit. Proverbs says, though a righteous man falls 7 times, he rises again.
If you're looking for a reason to finish, I'll give you one reason. God told you to do it. Be a finisher.
It has been another great week at COP.